It was a very different time, Mr. Kim. Captain Sulu, Captain Kirk, Dr. McCoy. Imagine the era they lived in.
No replicators.
One of our favorite sets to build this season. We brought a little bit of Captain Pike's history into the room. We've got a nice lounge area that Captain Lorca did not have. Being the captain of a starship has its perks, and one of them is actually an executive replicator and a completely stocked bar.
No replicators. You know, ever since I took Starfleet history at the Academy, I always wondered what it would be like to live in those days.
Power, that's no problem. It regenerates. And food, we have enough to feed a crew of 430 for 5 years.
The ship's supply of food concentrates couldn't have lasted 14 years.
After that, I found other things to eat.
He could not possibly have survived alone. The ship's food concentrates would have been exhausted in a year or so.
By which time he would have been eating fruits, vegetables,
probes
nuts.
Of stasis indicate very little.
I brought you a present.
It's my favorite. Where did you get it? They don't have any in the ship's stores.
It's a present.
Where did...
On Earth today, it's Thanksgiving. If the crew has to eat synthetic meatloaf, I wanted to look like turkey.
Captain Kirk from ship's galley.
Kirk here.
Sir, I put meatloaf in the ovens. There's turkeys in there now. Real turkeys.
Chief, have you...
Out of cereal? Troubles, you'll never run out of cereal again. Troubles is the only cereal with self-replication. Override your replicator safety protocols and set it for Tribbles. Original, Carry Berry.
The Enterprise has been assigned to escort two robot grain ships to Sherman's planet, which has been struck by crop failures and famine.
This shipment of seed grain, Quinto Triticale, is necessary to the survival of the colonists.
They're into the machinery, all right. And they're probably in all the other food processors, too.
How?
They seem to be gorged.
On my grain?
I, for one, could use a good non-reconstituted meal.
Doctor, you are a sensualist.
Further, the food synthesizers cannot manufacture enough food for the entire journey.
You know, when we finally get through this, I'd like to locate and raid a kitchen somewhere.
We have a crew of 300 turning their own quarters inside out, but the killers may still be among them.
Surely they have disposed of these booths by now.
Would it not have been logical to have left them on Gorkon's ship?
Even logic must give way to physics.
Why not simply vaporize them?
It's all right. It's nothing. It's nothing.
I'd like to locate and raid a kitchen somewhere.
Large salad. Enjoy.
Computer, 3 egg white breakfast burrito with black beans.
Computer.
Make it 2.
2 appetizing and nutrient-filled burritos.
Each card is a different flavor. You take your pick and the computer will mix your favorite combination. Now, what would you like? Just call out your favorites.
Coconut and vanilla. They're both white.
There, now, Stevie. There are unpleasant surprises as well as pleasant ones. That was your unpleasant surprise.
I'm just going to grab a sandwich and get me back to work.
One sandwich, that's all. Somebody turn off this infernal food factory.
Caesar salad.
It wasn't a particularly happy birthday.
We played 7 card stud and drank Synth Hall.
I was going through a hard time. She brought cards and Synth Hall, and we just played poker and drank until 0-100 hours.
Unless you want to keep brooding until your Synth Hall.
Synth Hall?
Hmm.
What in blazes is this?
Didn't you order scotch?
Captain Scott is unaware of the existence of Synthahol.
Synthahol?
It is an alcohol substitute now being served aboard starships.
She brought cards and Synthahol, and we just...
I seem to be all set. The replicator is a wonder.
It is green.
Well, it's green.
What can I do for you, Jim?
I said, give me the brandy!
Your computer here fixed about the best martini I ever had. Well, I might just get to like this place.
Uniform synthesis is complete.
I will need a Vulcan Desert soft suit and boots and a small selection of streetwear.
You've got it. I'll order the wardrobe section to prepare it now.
Have ship stores prepare the proper costumes.
What do you think about this? Or this one? I'll find what I need myself. Ship stores will have it.
Uniform synthesis is complete.
I'm positive I packed my dress uniform. I can't understand it.
It'll be fine.
Where's your uniform, Doctor?
Huh? I can't seem to find it, sir. I mean, I'm certain I packed it.
Listen to me. This is no dress rehearsal. This is the real thing. Before he was allowed to play, he was to place his soiled clothing in a garment reprocessor.
Every night, Miles leaves his socks on the floor. When we got married, I made the mistake of picking them up a few times. I bundled them up and put them in the cleaning processor. And I'm still doing it.
I don't know what's so difficult about putting a dirty dish back into the replicator.
See that the replicators provide a blanket for every man, woman, and child before nightfall.
Aye, sir.
I have brought you something. It's a matter replicator. It has limited capabilities, but will provide you with clothing, food.
But I'm buying these pajamas.
That'll be three strips of lino.
Two!
So, when it comes to keeping warm, nothing beats Vitarian wool undergarments. And in case you change your mind about those earmuffs, I'll keep them on hold for you.
I'll order the wardrobe section to prepare it now.
Uniform made of algae-based xenolon, I believe.
Aren't all our uniforms xenolon?
Yes.
That means only organic matter.
A replicator created this cup of coffee. Should that replicator be able to determine whether or not I can drink it?
Quadruple espresso with milk alternative?
Ill-advised. That amount of caffeine is ill-advised. Have a glorious day.
No replicators. No holodecks.
Injury. Mission success. Hologram battle simulation complete.
She is always so smart about these things. Oh, honey, look at your desktop. You're just so clearly over-caffeinated.
Computer, cancel mirror.
You look smart.
No replicators. No holodecks. You know, ever since I took Starfleet history at the Academy.
Took Starfleet history at the Academy.
Illogical! Illogical!